from East Hartford High School. This is, today is June 3rd, 2017, and we are here to witness the quarterfinal matchup between Southington and East Hartford High School for the 2016-2017 season. These teams have already faced each other twice, once in the regular season, then they've also faced each other in the championship for the CCC tournament, which was very recently, and both matches went to five sets. And East Hartford took both of them. So East Hartford is the CCC champion. Their records coming in here. Southington is 18-2, and they're ranked fifth in the tournament. And East Hartford is 16-1, and they are ranked fourth in the tournament. I'm just double checking my records here. Southington, yep. Yeah, they faced each other twice, and both times it went to five sets. And they've been in some matchups. The championship match for the CCC tournament, which was supposed to take place in a neutral venue, took place at Southington. And Southington won the first two sets rather handily. And then in the third set, East Hartford came back. And then they took the fourth set and the fifth set. So it was quite a comeback. Good turnout by East Hartford fans. Today, this is a Saturday. So it's still 10 minutes before start time. And East Hartford students are known for not showing up early. But hopefully they will indeed show up. This also happens to be prom weekend. Prom was yesterday on Friday, and that's actually when the game was originally scheduled to take place. But since practically the entire starting lineup for the Hornets is seniors, they requested, and CIAC complied in changing the date. I'll be with you in just a moment. So some more information for tonight. The winner of tonight's game will face the winner between Cheshire, who are ranked number one in this tournament, and Trumbull, who is ranked number nine. So that match was probably played yesterday. I don't know the results, but the assumption is that Cheshire went on. And then and that will be in the semifinal. On the bottom half of the draw, we have Darien and Ridgefield. Both made it, and they're going to play each other on June 5th at Fairfield Ward. Darien and Ridgefield are in the same conference. They're after each other all the time. Last year, they are the teams that faced each other in the championship game. And Ridgefield is the team that beat the Hornets in the semifinals. So, anyway, we'll be back in a few minutes, and I'm looking forward to this game, and I hope you are too. So it seems like the time has come for this whole thing to start. Now, on the last few matches I have done, I have had a history of missing one of the sets and perhaps leaving out the first set or the third set or something like that. So I'm going to try to do my utmost to get every single set in there this time. Not that I wasn't trying the other times, but somehow I need to avoid doing that. Coach Martinez and Southington's coach are having a friendly discussion there. They have seen each other many, many times. This is the third time this year.
Thank you.
This is a matchup that both teams want. Even if it wasn't a quarterfinal match, they would really, really like to beat one another. And this will be, I'd say that this will be the deciding match between them for the year, even though East Hartford has won two and Southington has not won any. I would say that this one is the one that determines who the winner of the series is this year. So on the court for East Hartford, we have Tyler Diaz, who's going to serve. We have Noah Galifi in the back, Jaden Oliveras in the front, Jonathan Trail, Emmanuel Ajman, and I don't see who the other one is. And that was Rafa Cruz is the other one. And East Hartford draws blood first. One serving zero. Tyler Diaz. Oh, Rafa Cruz attempts a soft shot. It goes into the net. Southington is now on the board. 1-1 is the score. Louis Giannopoulos serving for Southington. Hard serve. He is the captain for that team, and he's a very demonstrative player, as you will see. It drives the East Hartford players crazy. And I think it really helps his own team. So another hard serve. Oh, Rafa Cruz wasn't able to put it away the last time, but this time he did. 2-2. Enoch Ajman going up high for that one. There are three Ajmans on this team, and there are two Cruises. Four serving two. Jonathan Trail still serving. Nice block, and I think that was Tyler Diaz that got a hand on that one. He sure can jump for someone that's, he's the shortest man on the court right now, but he got that one. That one is blocked well. Goes back to Galifi. And that was Patrick Ajman that came in from the back to make that play. Six serving two. This is a much better start than East Hartford had at Southington in the last match. He went over the net for that one, but he deftly did so and didn't touch it. So the point goes to Southington, three serving six. Again, Rafa Cruz. And that was number six, Brian DeRocher, who had served for Southington. Pedro Oliveras comes into the game to serve. His serve has done well for the Hornets. That one goes out. 8 serving 3. The big man for Southington is Daniel Hackerman. Rafa Cruz, ball goes off the block, still in play. Oh, that was Patrick Ajuman trying to kill it from the back. Went into the net. He was a little bit too far for that play. And number 3, Andrew Chavez, will serve for Southington. And this time, Patrick Ajuman redeems himself. 9 serving 4. Rafa Cruz to serve. Oh, what a nice block. That looked like it was Emmanuel Ajuman going up for that one. 10 serving 4. And they let that one go, and it goes out of bounds. So 5 serving 10. The service will go to Southington. And number 14, Zachary Morgan, will be serving. He just came into the game. Into the net by Rafa Cruz. He'd been successful so far, but not that time. Morgan to serve again. Soft serve, just barely clears the net. And that went off the net, and a violation was called. I'm not sure what it was. 7 serving 10. Oh! And the net was touched on that one. Seemed like a nice play, but the net was touched. The Southington fans really like banging on the bleachers. It's one of the things they do. And so sometimes when you see the camera shaking, that'll be why. Rafa Cruz saves that. Wow, nice job. And Rafa Cruz again, he dives. Oh, that was nice. All of that effort by Rafa paid off. Substitution coming in. It looks like Patrick Ajuman's coming out. And Jacob Cruz comes in to serve. 11 serving 8. They let it go, and the ball was indeed out. God, that was a close one. You have to wonder as a player, do you take the chance and still go for it? Or just, I mean, if you let it go and it's in, that was an easy one. Timothy Walsh will serve. 9 serving 11. Another violation. I'm not sure what the nature of the violation was. The Hornets have had many this tonight. 10 serving 11. So Southington is now within one. And that was a nice play. That was number six, Brian DeRocher. The ball was blocked, but the block went out, and the game is tied. East Hartford was up by as many as 5 points earlier in the game. And it saved. Someone touched it. And it was Southington who touched it. One thing I appreciate about the Hornets players is that they never complain about calls, or I've never seen them complain about calls, yet players from other teams do. Soft toss, touched by DeRocher. The score is tied at 12, and looks like a substitution is coming in. This time it'll be number five, Nathan Simard, who's going to serve. And the big man, Jonathan Clark, comes out. 12-12, first set. Quarterfinal matchup of the 2016-17 state tournament. Two men went up. And Jonathan Trail prevailed on that one. Tyler Diaz will serve as the Hornets now lead by one, 13-12. DeRocher, what a save by Tyler Diaz. Jonathan Trail, soft play. Oh, nicely played. And it's nice to see hard defensive work like what Tyler Diaz did not go to waste. 14 serving 12. And that one is long. Oh, Mr. Martinez hates that. In the last matchup against Xavier, there were so many missed serves. East Harper still won the match without any trouble, but you don't want to miss that kind of play. And this time is number 15, Daniel Hackerman, that goes up high to block that. 14 all. The captain is serving again, Lewis. And Rafa Cruz lets that one go wisely. And the captain's name is Lewis Giannakopoulos. Greek name, I believe. Jonathan Trail to serve. Too long. Jonathan Trail again, 16 serving 14. Nicely blocked. That happened too fast. I don't know who it was. Southington calls a timeout, and East Hartford leads by 3 points. So on the court for the Hornets, Jonathan Trail, Noah Galifi, and Tyler Diaz in back, Patrick Ajuman, Rafa Cruz, and Enoch Ajuman in front. Here we go. Oh, soft touch. Not the way that it was on the drawing board, but it worked. 18 serving 14. Jonathan Trail will try it again. Rafa Cruz, it's saved by Janopoulos. And that one goes out. 19 serving 14, Hornets lead. They are within one of reaching the 20-point mark. Serve is good. It was long, but it was good. Oh, lucky touch on the net. Oh, point goes to the Hornets because it went off of DeRocher. The ball hit him last. So East Tarpon is within 5 points of taking the first set. Anything could still happen right now. As I said, Southington really likes doing that to the bleachers. Jonathan Trail still. This has turned out to be a great service run for the Hornets. Rafa Cruz gets up high. Soft touch over the guys at the net, yet too far for the guys in back. 15 serving 21, and DeRocher will serve. Ah, nice soft touch. I think that was, I was gonna say Patrick Hadjiman? I'm not sure. Okay, and Pedro de Jesus comes back in. 22 serving 15. East Tarpon is within 3 points of taking the first set. Oh, nice. Oh! He hit that one with authority. That was number 11, Timothy Walsh, and it was blocked extremely nicely. 23 serving 15. East Tarpon is within two, and Southington calls another timeout. So, Pedro de Jesus still serving. Hornets within two of taking the first set. Deflected slightly. I think that was it by Emmanuel Adjaman. 16 serving 23, and it'll be number. Let's see. Some substitutions on the floor, and it'll be number 3, Andrew Chavez, to serve. Serving 23. Rafa Cruz is on fire tonight. And he'll be serving. So it's going to be set point. East Hartford has 7 set points. Hopefully they'll just need the first one. There was a violation. And the point goes to Southington. It probably had something to do with too many East Hartford players in the front part of the court. So, 18 serving 24. Jonathan Trail, it's blocked. It's blocked. East Harper blocks the attempt to put it back. Oh, too close to the net. Too close. Can't hit that without hitting the net. 19 serving 24. So we have 5 set points. Yet, on the other hand, Southington is within 5 of tying up this game. 20 serving 24. East Hartford was on a good run there for a little while. They're making some silly mistakes all of a sudden. Nice block. That seemed like such a nice play, yet it went long. 21 serving 24. What at one point seemed like a commanding lead. So East Hartford takes a timeout. What at one point seemed like a commanding lead is now down to just 3 points. Very short timeout by the Hornets. I believe that Coach Martinez just wanted to see if he could break the momentum, because he certainly didn't take the time to go over some very, very complicated plans or anything, at least not in that amount of time. Okay, so number 14, Zachary Morgan serving. 3 set points left for the Hornets. Momentum is with Southington right now, until that. And that was Emmanuel Adjeman that went up for that one. The Hornets lead 1 set to nothing. And we will take a 3-minute break. So, let's see. So we have a relatively good crowd for the Hornets. You can see Mr. Ryan over there, okay, pointing down from the floor. Behind him, you can see Cameron Edwards, okay. There's Miss Johnson is in the crowd. Concession stand here. So Hornets are back on the court. Southington is getting ready to come in. All of a sudden you have a blue tint on the screen. I'm not sure exactly why. Hope that's not Southington blue. I'm gonna take the automatic off and I'm gonna leave that. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I think that looks a lot better. So on the court, we have Jaden Oliveros, Emmanuel Agyeman, Rafa Cruz, Jonathan Trail, Tyler Diaz, and Enoch Agyeman. And for Southington, we have, number 11, Timothy Walsh, number 14, Zachary Morgan, number 15, Daniel Hackerman, number 22, Jonathan Clark, number 2, the captain, Louis Giannopoulos, and number 6, Brian DeRocher, who had some really, really good plays earlier in the game. East Hartford leads 1-0. Here in their third matchup of the year, but this is the one that really, really matters. One of these teams will go on to play the winner between Cheshire and Trumbull. Here we go. And the first one is good. Enoch Agyeman, the service by Tim Walsh. One serving, nothing. Tyler Diaz is serving. Soft serve. Those serves that just barely clear the net are the most dangerous of all. And as you may have noticed, it hasn't happened yet tonight, but in volleyball, if the ball hits the net and still goes in, the serve is good. There was a time that that wasn't the case. And apparently, I was talking to Mr. Martinez just a few days ago. That rule change went into effect about 7 years ago. Another thing that changed was the side out. It used to be that you could only win a point if it was on your own serve, like in ping pong. But that has now changed, as you have seen from this game, and it makes the game a lot quicker. It looks like the referee called a carry for Rafa Cruz there. It wasn't the head referee, it was the assistant referee. And Nathan Samard will serve. One serving, three. Jonathan Trail. Four serving, one. That was a nice play by DeRocher. It was blocked, but the block didn't work. Two serving, four, and it looks like Giannopoulos will serve. Always a hard serve by Giannopoulos, this time a little bit too high and too hard. Five serving, two, and Pedro de Jesus comes in for the Hornets. Oh, Rafa Cruz, too hard, too high. Three serving, five. Brian DeRocher will serve. Jonathan Trail, Noah Galifi sends it up. Oh, not enough on that. DeRocher will serve again. Four serving five. Jonathan Trail again. Rafa Cruz is going to try this one. Didn't hit it as hard as he normally does, but that's one great advantage. When you hit it as hard as you do, people are always expecting it. And a miss hit can actually work out pretty well. Unless we'd like to assume that Rafa planned it to be a little bit softer. There, that looks more like the Cruz that we've come to know. What a save. Whoa, what a save that was. And I mentioned earlier the demonstrative captain for Southington. There you saw him. He's the one who made that play, and he's very excited. Five serving six. That was an awfully good save. Jonathan Trail, soft play. He can't do what he wanted to with it. Oh, Rafa Cruz changes his mind at the last moment. He second-guessed himself. And the game is tied, and the Hornets will call a timeout. And I will honor your request to put the shoes back on, okay? Oh, another nice save. Oh, not quite. Jonathan Trail hit it from the back. The save was, it was a nice dive, but it came up short, hit the top of the net. Hornets will serve. Jacob Cruz will be serving. Seven, serving six. Blocked. Oh, that was, oh, that was not the way they planned that one. Two guys went up for that one. You gotta sort of wait for the referees to decide what they want. It could have gone either way as far as I know. Six serving eight. Jacob Cruz again. DeRocher hits it hard. Saved by Cruz to the other Cruz. Again, Cruz sends it over. Oh, and that is Emmanuel Agyeman that once goes up high to block a kill by Johnson. Jacob Cruz again, nine serving six. Oh, Emmanuel Agyeman. So far that timeout is really paying dividends. Jacob Cruz, 10 serving six. Soft serve. Oh, blocked by Jonathan Trail, and it went off to the side where no one was. 11 serving six. That one goes out. Hornet ball again, 12 serving six. Jacob Cruz will want to watch some of this on Monday in our Spanish class. Maybe after we finish our Spanish work, maybe. I was afraid Ajuman had touched the net on that one, but he pulled his hands back and he didn't touch the net, and all of a sudden the Hornets are up 13-6. Nice run. One thing that happens in these tournament matches is that all of the referees are provided by CIAC. In regular matches, the linesmen are provided by, each team provides one, and obviously they're not quite as reliable, and you never know, you know, a call is made, you know, a team gets upset, but here, you know, you're pretty certain that the call that's being made is the right one. 14 serving six. Jacob Cruz. Johnson goes up high and touches the net, I think. 15 serving six. Amazingly good run for the Hornets right now. DeRocher goes up high and sends that at a very steep angle with two hands. Normally you achieve that steep angle with just one, but he goes up high. 7 serving 15, and it is number 14, Zachary Morgan serving here. Nice block, but nice save by Galifi. And now Rafa Cruz, it's saved by Southington. Too many touches there. 16 serving seven. Now, so the old way, the way scoring used to happen 7 years ago and beyond, there would have been no point on that one. Just the serve would have gone to, oh. Rafa Cruz tried, but that one was moving too fast. 8 serving 16, and number 17, Daniel Hunter will serve. I don't believe I've seen him in this game before. Jonathan Trail, the block goes out. 16 serving 8. And Tyler Diaz will serve. Also in the game now, Jaden Oliveros in back, and Noah Galifi in the middle. Oh, that was a nice play by Giannopoulos. Faked the blockers out big time. Tyler Diaz likes to do that for the Hornets. I haven't seen him do it yet tonight, but I saw them practicing that play before the game started. trail. Cruz. Oh, soft touch. Once again, they're always expecting Cruz to hit it hard. Now they don't know anymore. Jonathan Trell will serve. 18 serving 9. Galifi. Cruz. Block goes out. 19 serving 9. The Hornets have their biggest lead yet in this set. They lead by 10. Trail serves again. And that one is in. Nice play. Was it Giannopoulos who went up for that one? I'm not sure. If so, he's been having a very nice set, even though they are behind by 9. So this time it'll be Giannopoulos serving. You may recall he has a hard serve. When he hits it right, it is almost unstoppable. Goes out. 20 serving 10. So East Harper is within 5 points to take in the second set. Pedro de Jesus, and the timeout is called. Hornets are out on the court first. De Jesus, Jonathan Trill, Tyler Diaz, Rafa Cruz, Patrick Adjaman, and Emmanuel Adjaman. And here comes Southington. By number 10, William Fonzelt. I think it's the first time I've seen him in the game. 21 serving 10. Hard, hard serve. De Jesus doesn't often serve hard like that, so Enoch Adjaman comes back in. Pedro De Jesus comes out. No. I'm not sure who's in. Rafa Cruz, Noah Galifi, Jonathan Trail in the back, Tyler Diaz, Patrick Adjaman, and Emmanuel Adjaman in the front. Rafa Cruz, hard, and it's good. Serving 11. East Harford is within 3 points of taking the second set. Oh, what a save. Went off the rafters, still good. And that ball was too hard to get. 12 serving 22. Nice. And Andrew Chavez comes back in to serve for Southington. Rafa Cruz, too hard. 13 serving 22. Now the Hornets had a really big lead in the second set. And then all of a sudden, they started making some mistakes and Southington got closer and closer. And now it's 14 serving 22. Still a big lead, but I'm just saying. Oh, nice save. Hajiman went up high for that one. And it was Chavez who got to it. Almost got to it again. Serving 14. Jacob Cruz is serving. Last time he served, that really went well for the Hornets. And there's a change happening for Southington. Number 12, Rocco Pasadanto, is coming in for number 22, Jonathan Clark. A lot of kids coming in from the Southington bench who hadn't seen much of any time till this point. Oh, that looked like it was a nice save by Southington, but no, it was out. Jacob Cruz, set point, 24-14. And that was number 12, Pasadanto, who had just come into the game, who went up high for that one. 15 serving 24. Zachary Morgan comes in to serve for Southington. You can't do that. I'm sure that Tyler Diaz was not trying to pass it to himself, but that's how it ended up happening. 16 serving 24. East Harvard has a possible 8 set points that they can use here. And they did not need them. So they take the second set somewhat comfortably as they now lead 2-0. In the quarterfinal match of the state tournament for 2016-17. Okay, here we are, third set. East Harford leads 2-0. Tyler Diaz will serve. And East Harford takes that one, 1-0. Now, one thing to remember is that the last time these two teams met, it was at Southington, and Southington won the first two sets rather handily, and then East Hartford came back in the third. So it can be done. So Southington can still pull this out. Oh. Jaden Loriveros almost threw himself over there. I'm glad he didn't. I know those walls are padded, but they only accomplish so much. Okay, so Giannakopoulos to serve. One serving two in the third set. And Jonathan Trail will serve. Three serving one. Four serving one. Yes. Rafa Cruz. Five serving one. Quick move by Enoch Ajiman. Six serving one. Jonathan Trail again. Too far, seven serving one. Another nice little run by the Hornets. And Trail serves into the net. And it'll be Brian DeRocher serving for Southington. Two serving seven. Rafa Cruz again. Pedro de Jesus comes in to serve. Eight serving two. And that was good by number eight, Connor Brush. Number five, Nathan Simard comes in to serve. Three serving eight. Jeez. The point finally goes to Southington, as I believe it was carried by the Hornets. Four serving eight. And that was Emmanuel Ajiman trying to hit the ball, kick the ball up. I believe that is allowed, but I mean, not normally recommended. Soft touch by Rafa Cruz is no good. All of a sudden, six serving eight. Mini run by Southington. Miscommunication at the front. And Martin Martinez calls a timeout, which is rather wise under the circumstances. Emmanuel Adjaman going up high for that one. Rafa Cruz will serve, 9 serving 7. Oh, Galifi got that one back. Still alive, Tyler Diaz sends it over. Saved by Jonathan Trail. Rafa Cruz goes up high. Great point, both teams. Soft touch. DeRocher from the back. Adjaman is there. Adjaman again blocks it. And nice block by Johnson. Rafa Cruz, it hits the net. What a shame for that point to end that way. That's not the way that point was meant to end. I mean, great for the Hornets, but that point could have gone on for a while. Ten serving 7, Rafa Cruz. He couldn't do anything with it. I have no idea how these guys have the reflexes to get some of those balls back. I just don't comprehend. But I'm glad that they can. Zachary Morgan to serve. Soft touch over the net, and it's saved. Rafa Cruz comes from the back, and he gets one. 11 serving 8, and Jacob Cruz will serve. And that was Jonathan Trell that got up high for that one. 12 serving 8. miss hit by Zachary Morgan. 13 serving 8. Some nice block by Ajuman. 14 serving 8. And that one is out. Southington lets it go. And it is now number 11, Timothy Walsh, to serve. Yes. Jonathan Trail, soft touch over the blockers. 15 serving 9, Emmanuel Ajuman to serve. For some reason, I don't remember Ajuman serving at all for quite some time. Looks like Southington is making sure that all of their players get into this game. Very nice thing of the coach to do. That one goes long. And Jonathan Pearson has joined the game for the first time for Southington. Ajuman, 17 serving 9, a timeout is called. And I'm happy to say that as of now, I have recorded everything. Nothing has gone wrong. Probably stupid of me to say such a thing because, you know how that goes. Ajuman to serve. 17 serving 9. Trail saves it. Oh, no good. So it's 10-17. And it will be Pearson to serve. Nope. It will be Andrew Chavez coming in. He's no longer playing as the libero. Nice play. 18 serving 10. Giannakopoulos to serve. Twelve serving 18. Cantrell goes up high for that one. And Jonathan Trell will be serving. They let that one go. 13 serving 19. Serving 13. East Dartford is within 5 points of taking this match. Jonathan Trell will serve. Nope. Pedro de Jesus just came into the game. And he will serve. Nope. And just as quickly as he came in, he comes out. And Noah Galifi comes in. Nathan Samard, who's now playing as the libero for Southington, will serve. 14 serving 20. And the first one is good. Serving 20. They are within five of catching the Hornets here in the third set. And there was a violation. I believe the net might have been touched. I think he might have touched it with his back. 16 serving 20. They're within four. Serving 20. They're within three. Things can change so quickly in a game like this. A few minutes ago, the score was 19-10. Block goes into the net. The Hornets have their first point in a while. Rafa Cruz will serve. East Dartford is within 4 points of taking this match. Cruz gets to it, but they aren't able to do anything with it. And William Fanfelt comes into the game and he will serve. 18 serving 21. Serving 18. Jacob Cruz comes in. He will serve. East Harper is within 3 points of taking this match. Jonathan Trell. 23 serving 18. East Dartford is within 2 points. And the serve is good. And it's set point. Set point. Some people in the Southington crowd didn't like that. Yeah. And that is good as Timothy Walsh goes up high for that one. 19 serving 24, and Timothy Walsh will serve. The Hornets are within 1 point, so they have five possible set points here. Jonathan Trail, and that's it. That's it. The Hornets will go on. They will play in the next match between the winner of Cheshire and Trumbull. The next match is scheduled to take place on Tuesday, June 6th. The site has yet to be determined. And then as it stands, the championship game is scheduled to take place. Actually, it doesn't say what time the match will be. And then the championship game, if they were to get that far, would be on Thursday, June 6th. Site and time to be determined. Thank you very much for watching. Great game. The Hornets have a really, really strong team this year.